Mr. President, Mr. Secretary General, Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen. It is my great honor to join all of you here today to congratulate the Secretary General and, for that matter, global community for the adoption of the post 2015 agenda. It is a privilege to thank you for this signal achievement. And it is fitting that we take this uniquely important moment to recognize the hard work and dedication of literally thousands of people from all nations that has allowed us to gather here today. By virtue of that work, by so many, we now have a strong set of imperatives for the transformational change that our people and our countries need safeguard our planet for the future of our children. It is also with a deep gratitude and humbleness that I recognize and acknowledge the leadership of His Holiness, Pope Francis, for his inspirational remarks and for his extraordinary encyclical Laudato Si. That profoundly important document laments the careless use of our planet's resources, leading to environmental degradation and global warming. This encyclical on climate change, calling for swift and unified global action, is an inspiration to us all, and is already beginning to change hearts and minds and to focus the world's attention on the most vulnerable amongst us and our Mother Earth. The encyclical clearly eloquently states a fundamental truth. What we do or do not do about climate change today will affect the lives of countless people for many generations to come. His Holiness speaks passionately of the impacts of climate change and the sufferings of the poor. This also is fundamental. The people who contribute least to this crisis are suffering the most from it. This realization must be part of the solution we develop in Paris at the end of the year. There is still time to tackle climate change, the greatest challenges of our time. Human suffering and the suffering of all creation will depend with each moment of delay. At the same time, all countries and all people have a role to play in building a more sustainable future. Ladies and gentlemen, the 8 Millennium Development Goals help drive global progress in developing countries. Most assuredly, they help to reduce extreme poverty, improve health, enhance environmental sustainability, and address gender equality. Today, we have before us the new Sustainable Development Goals. These new SDGs are critically important as the next great step forward beyond the MDGs. These SDGs must raise the bar of our global commitment to finally address the root causes of poverty and environmental degradation. And, as we all know, we have enormous challenges ahead. Over 1 billion people on this fragile planet still live on less than $1.25 a day. Almost 1 billion people do not have enough to feed themselves or their families. Climate change is already wreaking havoc in my home, the Pacific. Our nations are at present feeling the effects from rising seas, storms, surges, droughts, floods, and ocean acidification that together threaten our water and food supplies, our marine biodiversity, and our very livelihoods. Of course, these enormous challenges are not limited to my region. As our new agenda recognizes, there is no region on earth, country and no people who are not suffering and who will not continue to suffer until we take effective and long-lasting global action. Like the Millennium Development Goals, the Sustainable Development Goals are but a blueprint for change and regeneration. The hard work indeed lies ahead for our global community, rich and poor nations alike, to make these goals real across the broad expanses of our planet and for all of our cities. In Palau, we are working hard to do our part and to take those next steps that will define our future. We have committed to providing 20% of our energy through renewable energy resources by 2020 and are already 3/4 of the way here. We have also committed to become carbon neutral by 2050. Within these countries, we have finalized a comprehensive climate change policy and will soon submit our intended nationally determined contribution. And we are working hard to protect our ocean, the foundation of our culture, and the backbone of our livelihoods. We have created a comprehensive network of nearshore marine protected areas and are in the process of establishing the Palau National Marine Sanctuary, which will close 80% of our exclusive economic zone in an area the size of France to commercial fishing. As a small island developing nation, I must particularly congratulate and thank all of you on the Ocean Sustainable Development Goal. This Ocean's SDG is enormously important to all of us. It will pave the way towards a healthier global marine environment through which a well-connected system of marine protected areas, restoration of fish stocks, and the elimination of illegal, unregulated, and unreported fishing will be addressed. Mr. Secretary General, while small nations like mine are taking many actions on our own to stem the tide of environmental collapse, it is only through a true global partnership for sustainable development, with the participation of all countries, all stakeholders, and all people, that we can implement our new list of sustainable development goals with the speed and scale necessary to respond to our urgent situation. To move forward, we will need the funding and technical support to implement, monitor, and strengthen our solutions. And we will need this support sooner rather than later. Ladies and gentlemen, global partnership is our only hope. Only through real partnerships at every level can we implement SDGs in our generation to indeed transform the world. Only through partnership can we hope to realize the promise of the future we want, a future we need for our children and all the generations to come. Thank you, and God bless our mother.